Good morning and welcome to Sunday School. Has anyone ever asked you a hard question? Did you know the answer? What do you do if you don't know the answer? In our story today, some people tried to trick Jesus with some really hard questions. Before we get into our story, I hid something in this bag. I asked my daughters to ask some yes or no questions to see if they could figure it out. I'll read their questions and give you the answers I gave them. Let's see if you can guess what is in here based on her questions. All right, first question. Is it made out of metal? No. Next question. Does it start with the letter B? No. Is it bigger than a diaper? No. Does it go in a school? Yes. Is it round? Kind of. Is it a cylinder? Yes. All right, she guessed what the item was after that question. Did you? All right, let's see what's in there. It's a glue stick. Did you get it right? Asking questions helps us learn and discover new insights. In the Bible, people asked Jesus questions. Many wanted to gain a deeper understanding of his teachings or who he is. However, the religious leaders often asked Jesus questions to try to trick him. They thought that they were wiser than Jesus. Last week, we learned a new big picture question. Do you remember it? Our question is, how is Jesus the perfect prophet? Let's repeat the question together. How is Jesus the perfect prophet? And the answer to our question is, Jesus perfectly reveals God the Father and fulfills what the prophet spoke. Let's say the answer together. Jesus perfectly reveals God the Father and fulfills what the prophet spoke. In our story today, Jesus showed the religious leaders that he is God because he knows all things. As the perfect prophet, Jesus is not surprised or tricked by questions because he knows all truth, and he is truth. He answered their questions and proved that he is the Messiah that God promised to send. All right, now it's time to watch our Bible story.
The religious leaders heard Jesus' teaching in Jerusalem. They decided to send some men to ask Jesus tricky questions to catch him saying something wrong. The men said, "Teacher, we know you tell the truth. Is it right to pay taxes to Caesar or not?" Jesus knew what they were doing. "Why are you trying to trick me?" he asked. "Show me the coin you use to pay taxes." The men brought him a denarius. Jesus asked, "Whose picture is on the coin? Whose name is on it?" "Caesar's," they answered. Jesus said, "Then give to Caesar what is Caesar's, and give to God what belongs to God." The men were amazed at what Jesus said, and they went away. Later, the religious leaders came to question Jesus again. "Teacher, which command in the law is the greatest?" they asked. Jesus answered, "Love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. The second most important command is like it. Love your neighbor as yourself." Then Jesus asked the religious leaders a question. "Whose son is the Messiah?" "David's," they said. "How can that be?" Jesus asked. "David called the Messiah Lord. Why would he do that if the Messiah is his son?" The religious leaders didn't know what to say. Their plan had failed, and no one was brave enough to ask him any more questions. When the religious leaders questioned Jesus, he answered with wisdom and power. "Jesus is the Messiah, the Son of God. He is the Word of God who came to show us exactly what God is like."
In today's lesson, we learn that the religious leaders asked Jesus questions. Asking questions is not wrong, especially when we're wanting to know God and love him more. However, the religious leaders' questions were not asked because they wanted to learn and grow. What were the religious leaders trying to do with their questions? They were trying to trick Jesus. They wanted to confuse him and get him to say something wrong so they could have a reason to find him guilty. But Jesus is not guilty because he is perfect. The religious leaders thought they were being sneaky, but Jesus knew what they were up to. He cannot be tricked because Jesus knows all things. How did the religious leaders act when Jesus answered their questions? The religious leaders were amazed at first, and then they stopped asking Jesus questions because their plan had failed. They were not wiser than Jesus. Each time Jesus answered their questions, he showed that he is God. Jesus is all-knowing and came to show people that he is the Messiah God promised to send. We can trust in Jesus and believe in him for salvation. Now, let's watch Questions from Kids.
Hi there, I'm Pastor Kevin. It's time for Questions from Kids. Zara from Indianapolis, Indiana asks,
I played a trick on my sister and she got upset. Is tricking people wrong?
Well, Zara, that is a great question, and I'm really delighted to answer that. You know, my kids love trying to play tricks on me, and I say trying because oftentimes they fail, and trust me, they have some good ones. And sometimes I like to play tricks on them. One of the things we try to keep in mind as a family is this trick out of love? And will everyone, including the person that's being tricked, enjoy it and laugh? In some cases, it can be sin, and in other cases, not. It really depends on the person's heart who's doing the trick. Is the heart being deceitful, wanting to cause embarrassment or shame or even harm to someone else? And it also depends on the impact. Will this trick hurt someone physically or emotionally or socially? Here's a tip that I want you to have. If you're not sure, just don't do it. Here's one thing we are absolutely sure of in today's passage. The religious leaders had wicked hearts, and they wanted to embarrass and to hurt Jesus. One of the things we must keep in mind is that many of the tricks that we do come from the things that come out of our mouth. And Proverbs 18 warns us that life and death are in the tongue. So be very careful to watch the words that come out of your mouth. Remember that tricking people can be really, really harmful and is oftentimes tied to lies and things that are untrue. The truth is always better. The truth is always best. How can you show others what Jesus is like by being truthful? I would love to hear from you. If you have a question, email me at gospelproject.kids@lifeway.com, and next time I might be answering a question from you.
Is tricking people wrong? Why? How can you show others what Jesus is like by being truthful? All right, now let's look up our key passage again. It's Deuteronomy 18:15. Go get your Bibles. Okay, we're gonna start in the table of contents, and Deuteronomy is in the Old Testament, and it is the fifth book right there. So we're going to scroll over to that side and see what the page number is. It's on page 195 in this Bible. So I'm going to flip over to page 195, and there's Deuteronomy. And then we need to find the chapter 18. And the chapters are the big numbers like that. So there's chapter 1. You need to find chapter 18. So we're going to have to turn a couple pages. There's 17. There's chapter 18 right there. And then we need the verse number 15. So we're going to go down and look at these tiny, tiny little numbers. And verse 15 is right there. The Lord your God will raise up for you a prophet like me from among you, from your fellow Israelites. You must listen to him. In our story, we learned that rather than listen to Jesus, the religious leaders tried to trick Jesus. Our key passage reminds us that it is wise to listen to Jesus and his words. He is the perfect prophet. All right, would you pray with me? God, thank you for Jesus. We praise you for Jesus and how he came to save us. Help us trust in him and listen to his words. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next week. Bye.